environment for the animals in captivity. They are native to central and southwestern China, but there are estimated to be only 1,600 pandas left in the wild. Very sweet. See you soon.
Thanks a lot, Georgie.
Whatever.
They sound like little kids, aren't they?
Pandas.
Yeah.
Don't get into them.
Hard-hearted cubs.
They're useless things.
Just ask Bamboo.
There are some things in the world that just need to be
pretty,
cute.
Are just pretty.
They just need to be cute, and they're doing the world a very good service. How can you not
look,
melt?
What is it doing?
It's just being adorable. Look at that. Doesn't it just remind you of you on a late Friday night?
Well, that does.
Good luck with teaching them anything. I went to that place after the earthquake.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And they are fascinating to watch, but they solve every problem by dropping onto their head.
You could do that too. Main thing is, slate category going to be big for Christmas, and iPad's going to have some good competition coming along, which
All right.
Great to see.
I feel like Dickie in the 80s. I'm just going to have a look at my black book.
Thank you, Charlie.
Good great night. Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
Very cool. Very good advice there. Thank you very much
Thank
for that.
You.
So,
thanks, Susan.
Lisa, next time you've got a headache at night before you go to sleep, and Pete, says, what about,
yeah.
And you say, no, I've got a headache, he's going to pull out one of these.
Or a potato. Nice.
Maybe this is what I should be eating.
Or one of those.
Weather next.
All over, isn't it?
It is.
It's good having it as a backup on the TV.
Yeah. What do you mean, like
on?
When the Today Show's on?
No.
Is that what you've been doing in the breaks?
I mean, in the afternoon. In the afternoon.
Thanks for that, Alicia.
That's karma.
Man.
Right there.
They would have done
something
to your brains just then.
Welcome back to the Today Show. Good to have your company today. It is not good to have the company of all of these bloody seagulls. It's not funny. These things attack, you know. What are you doing? That's not funny. That is not funny. All right, it is time now for...
It's a bit cold around the country at the moment, but lazy patch, let me tell you. Ooh, these things are warm. It's like wearing a sleeping bag, Carl.
What things?
Starting to get a little bit dizzy in this thing. Jenny Craig should get onto this, I tell you.
I think we need a full frame.
There it is.
What's he wearing?
Comes in different colours, red, blue. Also comes in army colours. Those who want to get out and about. Just take a little bit of a sip, I think. Feeling a bit faint. That's the that's the weather map up there.
Is like he loves the heater, and that's great, but you've obviously got safety issues when it comes to your animals.
Oh.
Are you okay?
You're all right.
Oh.
I can't really offer advice because
I don't quite know what to say either. Are you okay there, Carl?
Should we just go forward?
Yeah.
Do you need a heat pad?
Right.
This is a heat pad. Are you okay?
That's not funny. That pug, I never liked that thing as soon as I saw it.
I think she's gorgeous.
She's beautiful.
They're quite powerful.
They're very strong little dogs. They're
Aren't
solid.
They?
They're solid, muscular little dogs.
Launched from their back legs.
Yeah.
Perhaps you could paint a picture for everyone at home, because I'm struggling at the moment.
Maybe it's getting a little bit keen. And take a look at the weather and see what's happening right around the country.
Wait, jeez! Back off! Slow it down. Take it easy. If you want to lift a 200, just back off.
Oh, you're big meanie, Stevie.
Oh, man, now I feel bad.
Yes.
Okay, come on, Hugo, it's all right. Good, Hugo.
See you tomorrow. I'll say, allez, look a mule, tomorrow.
Mm.
And, kiss we.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Hope a coconut hits you in the head.
Thanks,
Tiger Woods changing his putter. Not good. It's like changing your wife. No good can come from it.
No good can come from it. Very expensive.
Do you know what you just said?
No. But I am going on holidays in 25 minutes. I'll leave you with the emails. Today at 9.com.
Changing your putter, like changing your wife.
You don't do it, right, is what I'm saying.
I think we'll move on. Coming up after the weather. Come on, Mona Lisa. We only have 30 seconds. Who's a good loser? Who's a good loser? Alicia
is. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You actually look very, very good, Alicia.
Yeah, black and white suits you.
Goes with red very well.
Yeah, see, look.
This is the hardest thing I've ever had to do.
Abby, what do you think? Does she look good?
I think it's very slimming the way the stripes
are. Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye,
happy birthday, you guys.
As we say, this job has its ups and downs, but today, particularly so. Good work, Schmicko.
Thank you, Stevie. It's not that hard, you know.
Yeah. And neither is hosting a morning show, Carl.
Exactly. Yeah, we've made a meal out of that too. Husband, because they are so jealous, he has nodded off before them. Some confess to talking until they get a response from him to wake him up. Others make a noise or even turn on the television. Does that happen in your house?
It might. Now, what most annoys you about your partner's sleeping habits? Today at 9.com.au. See, that's us getting you back for those moments when we're just dropping off to sleep and for some bizarre reason you want to wake us up. You know the prod? The wake-up prod? Because you want to have a chat. You know that.
I don't want to chat when I get into bed.
Really?
No.
Are you... What's a bed look like once you've left it?
What?
I have a husband that when he... That I can have a beautifully, freshly made, just washed sheets.
Yes.
When he leaves the bed, the whole thing looks like a disaster zone. Drives me nuts.
Well, is there anything else you'd like to say this morning on Oprah?
Well, I did say, do you want multiples of 10 on what my husband does in bed?
Georgie, anything annoys you?
There is this pesky toe that just sort of digs into my leg.
It is Tim's, isn't it?
Does it have a toenail on that?
Dickie?
I'm not going anywhere near this conversation at all. Do you realise people are watching us and listening to us?
Yeah, probably in bed.
Yeah. Number one reason why couples are sleeping apart these days?
What?
Snoring.
Yeah.
Women can't cope with it anymore. Because, see, we don't snore.
I think it's a good idea, Georgie. What do you think?
Oh, I think it's sad.
Why?
Because I love spooning.
What?
Spooning.
Yeah.
How can you spoon in separate rooms, Carl?
Don't you get hot and, like, bothered?
Yeah, well, that's...
Well, it's up to you, isn't
it? And I reckon we should mount some sort of campaign to get Matilda back into the shape that she was and bring her back out.
I agree.
She's
with
an important
you.
Part of our history, Matilda.
I agree with you.
Was somebody towing it up the highway and they just ran out of petrol, or do we know what the link is with
it? It could have
station?
Been. It could have been. No, that's a bit Priscilla Queen of the Desert, that image, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
With the scarf flowing back behind. But I reckon it may not be true. It's an unconfirmed report, but that's where we think she's located.
Well, she is a national treasure, as you say. Sure she should is. Be restored to her former glory.
Yeah. I share your indignation.
Can we...
We need to start a campaign.
Yeah, let's get this campaign going. Today at 9.com.au. We'll need a place to put her, preferably someone's house in a cul-de-sac.
Yeah.
Maybe in the backyard.
Yep.
Four stories, because we want her out of the rain. We don't want any more damage.
Yeah, well, some people have got very big sheds. As Georgie pointed out too, she's inspired a whole new generation of people. For example, Miranda Kerr.
That week. Good call.
Very good call, Georgie.
Yeah.
So she continues to inspire Australians.
Octo Mum. She inspired Octo Mum. Did you see how many kids just ran out of it?
Amazing. And it goes on. Oh, if only childbirth was that easy.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's move on. Thank you, Kev.
All right, no worries.
Excellent contribution this morning.
At the school. We have been flooded with emails on this one. What about for all the women called gay?
Yes.
Should they change their name?
Probably.
According to this school principal, yes.
Definitely. And I've got a poof at home that I love.
Well, don't we all love
a poof? Oh, we all love a poof.
Who doesn't love a poof?
You're not alone there.
I've got a favourite poof I had for 5 years.
Mm. I loved my poof so much, it died.
You can love a poof too much. So what do we do about that?
Exactly.
You know, it's just obscene. No. You never thought you'd go to this level, did you, little darling?
Peter Fitzsimons has a great book out called A Simpler Time, right? This is a great Father's Day item for if you're a mature sort of a person. But if you're immature like me, there's something called the Nerf gun.
It's the stick.
It's the stick.
See you, everyone.